Charles, I lied.
No.
I'm so sorry. In fact, it turns out that there is no tweak that you can do to these algorithms to make the trifecta, to have all three of these properties. And in fact, there is no clustering algorithm. It is impossible to derive a clustering algorithm that has these three properties. So this was proven by Kleinberg. And what he showed is that once you define these three different properties, richness, scale, invariance, and consistency, they are mutually contradictory in a sense. So just like we saw in the example that we went through in the quiz, where we tweak the algorithm and it gets us one, but it loses us another, that's a necessary property. You just can't have all these three hold at once.
That's really surprising coming from Kleinberg, because John is one of the nicest people I know in machine learning and theory. And you would think that he would have tried to find a possibility theorem, not an impossibility theorem. I'm very disappointed.
So he's got a dark side, is what I'm saying. This is a striking and maybe even upsetting result, right? It's saying that, you know, if you actually sit down and say, well, here's what I would like my clustering algorithm to be, which people hadn't really done very often, once you've bothered to do all that hard work of saying what matters to you and what doesn't matter to you, it turns out you can't have what you want. You can't always have what you want.
But can you get what you need?
In this particular case, maybe. It depends if you only need two of these.
Well, so how bad is this? So I agree it is a, at least to me, surprising result that you can't have all three of them. And it's a little disappointing because you would love to have an algorithm that does. Because I think we agree all three of these properties make sense, at least certainly independently
right.
to do. But just how bad is it? I mean, when you can't have all three, can you come close to having all three? Can you have like 2.9 of them?
Well, you can definitely have two of them because that's what we did in the quiz.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it kind of depends on what you can reinterpret some of these properties and get and nearly satisfy them. And I can point you to Kleinberg's paper to look into that. But I think I need to be done with this for now. I just wanted to give you a flavor of the idea that one of the reasons that clustering is kind of hard to pin down is because when you pin it down, it plays dead.
Hmm.
It's like an opossum. When you pin it down, it actually it turns out that it still doesn't really want to do what you want it to do. But in practice, what happens is people do clustering for lots of different reasons, and they're willing to change their clustering, like look at what actually comes out of it and change their notion of clustering so that it's more consistent with what they're trying to achieve. It's not great to use in this purely automated fashion where you just hand it over to the computer and be done with it, but it's still a really powerful thing to do to get to know your data better.
Okay. I accept that. I feel better now.